गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग द टॉपिक द सेंट्रल इस्लामिक लैंड। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस हाउ द इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ खलीफेट वाज ब्रोकन डाउन एंड देन न्यू सिस्टम दैट इज सल्तनत केम इनटू बी। चिल्ड्रन, एज वी हैव स्टडीड इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस दैट द capital of Arab countries was Medina. What was the capital? And then Umayyads changed its capital and they made Damascus its capital. Then they made Damascus. And then again Abbasid dynasty came into being and then Abbasids again changed this capital from Damascus to Baghdad. Now see, first what was the capital of Arab countries? That was Medina. Then Umayyad dynasty changed this capital from Medina to Damascus. Then from Damascus to Baghdad, it was changed by Abbasid dynasty. Now, at the time when there was a breakup of caliphate and there was a rise of sultanate, the capital of Arab countries was Baghdad. Now let's know what happened during the Abbasid dynasty. We have studied that during the Abbasid dynasty, the influence of the Arab countries declined, and though Abbasids focused on the creation and restoration of the Islamic institutions and Islamic culture, but still there was not a centralized power, and due to which there was a need of an empire and centralized government, as we have studied in the last class. But Abbasids could not manage the whole that is Ummah, that is a Muslim community which was spread in a large part of the world. That was from the Nile River in Africa to the Oxus in Central Asia, and till Iran also in the West Asia. The result was that there was a breakup of Caliphate, which was an institution which was running for a long period of time. Now let's know how it broke up and how new system, new institution, the Sultanate came, and whether during the period of Sultanate this Caliphate institution was totally abolished or not. This thing also is very important. Now let's know. Just see, there was a Caliph from Abbasid dynasty. The name was Harun Rashid. What was the name? Harun Rashid. He was a Caliph. Where he? From Abbasid dynasty. And he was having two sons. One was Amin and the other was Mamun. One was Amin, the other was Mamun. And they were not having same ideology. And one was favoring Arab countries and the other was favoring Iranians. The result was that there was a faction in the Abbasid army. And in the Abbasid army, there were soldiers who were pro-Arab, some were pro-Arab and some were pro-Iranians. And the same thing was in the bureaucracy also. Some were pro-Arabs and some were pro-Iran. The result was that there was a civil war which took place between the two sons of Amin and Mamun. And this civil war took place in 810 AD. Now let's see what was the result of this civil war. There were many changes. Like after the civil war, what happened that the new power block was in the existence. The name of that power block was Turkish power block, and Turkish power block was the group of slave officers, and slaves were called the Mamluks. So this group was also called the Mamluk group, and Mamluk it was called. And then there were other differences and changes came that different new dynasties started to come into existence. For example, there were Tahirs and Samanids. Tahirs and Samanids are the name of the new dynasties which came into existence. Somewhere came Khurasan also and Transoxanian also. And then there was another new dynasty came into existence. The name was Turonids. And Turonid dynasty came into existence in Egypt and Syria. So let's even know that after the civil war, there was one other power block came into existence, and that power block was the made from slave officers, and slaves were called the Mamluks, and this slave officers belong from the Turkestan. So this power block was called the Turkish power block. And then next was the change which came into existence. There were the emergence of many new dynasties. Like for example, Tahirs and Samanids came into existence in Khurasan and Transoxiana. And then next is Turonids, which came into existence in Egypt and Syria. After these changes, what happened that the control of the Abbasids on the Baghdad declined. Control on Baghdad declined, and they were having the control only in the part of western Iran and central Baghdad only, because in some part of the Baghdad they lost their control. Whatever the control now Abbasids were having, they also lost that due to the attack of Buyids. Buyids were the Shi'it clan from Iran. They attacked on 945 AD and captured Baghdad. Buyids started new dynasty, and they did not abolish the institution of caliphate, but they took a title, a new title that is Shahanshah, means king of kings, and they were not in the favor of abolition of the institution of caliphate. As we know that this Buyid dynasty did not abolish the institution of caliphate. The reason behind that was they were very sure they did not abolish it because there was another one dynasty and which was having ambition to rule over the whole Ummah, that is the Muslim community of the world. That was Fatimid dynasty. Fatimid dynasty was also belonging from Shi'it clan, and they declared themselves that they are the descendants of the daughter of Prophet Muhammad, Fatima. They said, who are the Fatimids? They said, Fatimid dynasty, who were the Fatimids? They said that they are the descendants of the Fatima, and Fatima is the daughter of the Prophet Muhammad. Ummah, so they have the legitimate right to rule over the whole Ummah, that is the Muslim community. This Fatimid dynasty attacked on Egypt in 969. Where they attacked? Egypt. In which year? 969. And they captured Egypt and they established here Fatimid dynasty. About the Beut dynasty and Fatimid dynasty in Egypt. That Beut dynasty were ruling in Baghdad and Arab areas, and the Egypt was under the control of the Fatimids. Now they both realized that there is a need of unity in Islamic world. That's why some changes were brought, and these changes were brought during the period of 950 to 1280. During this period, many changes were brought by these two dynasties and by the rulers, or we can say caliphs of these two dynasties. They focused on the development of the people, and this unity was not due to the political order, but these two there were two main reasons for the unity and for the unification of these Islamic world. Those two main reasons were, one was language and the other was cultural pattern. Now Beut dynasty also and Fatimid dynasty also, they focused on the development of the Persian language as the official language. And then cultural pattern. In Islamic culture, they focused on the development of this, and they gave freedom to the scholars and artisans and merchants. Islamic land. Now see about the scholars. Scholars were free to communicate and to have conversation with the people living in the Islamic land, and at the same time artisans were also free to move from one place to another place without any barriers in the Islamic land. And Islamic land means all the lands which were under the control of the Beuts also, Fatimids also, and other dynasties, and which were earlier was only controlled by the Umayyad dynasty, or before that caliphates. Now due to the changes of different dynasties, and the other dynasties came and into existence and brought new changes, and some parts were controlled, some parts were under their control. For example, Fatimids were having the control on Egypt. Now we have seen this. And then artisans were also having chance, and then merchants were also given freedom to move from one place to another place in the Islamic land. What was the result then? The result was conversation took place, and due to which there was a now Islam was able to identify, make its identification as a religion which was different from other religions. Means Islam की आजकल जो पहचान हो गई थी दूसरे सभी धर्मों से बहुत ही अलग and एक developed religion के रूप में उभर के सामने आया. The result was that there was a rise of the population of Muslims in the world. And in during the period of the Umayyad dynasty, it was only 10%, which increased during the 950 to 1200. It increased enormously. Means बहुत ही तेजी से मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन का विकास हुआ. And then means increase in case there was a very sharp increment in the population. And then जो है artisans की वजह से there was a large opportunities for the job. And then merchants की वजह से there was a development in the trade which gave rise to the economic growth of the empire. There was a new change that a new ethnic group came into existence. As earlier we have studied about Arabs and Iranians. Now let's study about the Turkish. They were the new ethnic groups and they came from the Central Asian steppes. Steppes means grasslands. They came from Central Asia steppes and they were very skilled riders and warriors. And they joined some dynasties, means they joined the army of the some dynasties like Samanids, Buyids and Abbasid dynasty also, and the army of Samanid dynasty also, and the army of Buyid dynasty also. Though they were very skilled warriors and riders, so with the capability and with the loyalty of their work and with the loyalty to their masters and by their good skill, they could get the promotion also in the army. We are paid and they were professional soldiers and they used to get jobs in the army of these dynasty and they used to work for their and instead of their work they used to get the payment. So they were the professional soldiers. And now just see, we have studied that about the Turkish, that it was a new ethnic group which joined. Earlier we studied only about Arabs and Iraqs and then to the Iranians. We knew about the Irans and the Arabs. Now we are studying about the Turkish, which belonged from the Central Asia steppes, that is steppes means grasslands, and they were very skilled riders and warriors. They used to join the army of the Samanids, Abbasid and Buyid dynasty, and with the loyalty of their master and with the skilled work they could get the they used to get the high position and high post in the army also, and they used to get the payment for that work.